In the last lecture, we dealt with thermodynamics. And the important thing that I told you is that thermodynamics deals with only bulk properties, only properties of large scale systems like pressure, volume, temperature, and internal energy. Internal energy is energy of a system due to the motion of microscopic particles. Then we also learned about various processes of thermodynamics: isothermal, when temperature is constant; isobaric, when pressure is constant; isochoric, when volume is constant; adiabatic, when there is no heat exchange. And we found in each of these processes the expression for the work done. Now, we have chosen a few problems from thermodynamics which illustrate whatever we have done in the last lecture. Let me give you a secret. Examiners are very fond of thermodynamics because they can find many problems to set in the examinations. And I have chosen problems to illustrate some of the things that we have done, and I hope that you would be able to not only solve these problems or similar problems, but also would understand how thermodynamics works. So, let us start with a simple problem. This problem has been taken from one of the entrance examinations. And the problem is: at 10 degrees Celsius, the value of density of a fixed mass of an ideal gas divided by its pressure is x. At 110 degrees Celsius, this ratio is, you see, when you read this statement carefully, also keep on thinking what is being asked and what is being given. You see, it says of a fixed mass, so mass is fixed. Ideal gas, so we can apply equation PV equal to RT. The temperature is given in degrees Celsius. Remember, in thermodynamics, we measure temperatures in absolute degrees or on Kelvin scale. So, if you remember these things, then this question is very simple. For a fixed mass, volume is inversely proportional to density. And from this equation of state PV equal to mu RT for an ideal gas, we can write P by rho proportional to T, or rho by P proportional to 1 by T. So, rho 2 by P 2 is equal to rho 1 by P 1 into T 1 by T 2. So, substitute the values and you get the answer. T 1 is 283 on Kelvin scale, T 2 is 383 on Kelvin scale, and using these values you get rho 2 by P 2, your data is all here, you get 283 by 383 times x, which is option 3. So, when you read a question or a problem, please see what is given, that is more important, and what formulae you can use to solve these problems. Again, let us take another question. 5 moles of a gas undergo expansion from volume V to volume 2V at a temperature of 27 degrees Celsius. The work done in the process in joule is approximately. So, see what is given? At a temperature of 27 degrees C, there is no change in temperature. So, the process is isothermal and the temperature is 300 degrees Kelvin. So, 5 moles are given. So, you all that you use is the work done, which we did in the last lecture. The work done is in an isothermal process is mu RT log of V 2 by V 1. Mu is 5, R is 8.31 along with its units, T is 300, and log of V 2 by V 1 you can find from any log tables, and you plug in the values and you get W equal to 8.6 times 10 to the power 3 joule, which is again option 3. So, remember, when you read the problem, you first of all try to figure out what is given and what relevant formulae you need to use. Again, question 3, 5 moles of a monoatomic gas are taken adiabatically from a state where its temperature is 27 degrees C to a state where its temperature is 127 degrees C. The work done in the process in joules is approximately. You see, the examiner is being clever again. The temperatures are given in degrees Celsius, but you must be cleverer. You must know that the temperature have to be measured in degrees Kelvin. So, convert them into degrees Kelvin if needed. Now, the process is adiabatic, and we have seen in the last lecture that the work done is mu r into T 1 by minus T 2 by gamma minus 1. So, substitute the values. For monoatomic gas, gamma is 5 by 3. So, and T 1 minus T 2 is negative. That means, the work is being done from outside. The work is being done on the system, on the gas, and the value of the work done is this. You can find easily. There is no problem. Obviously, the work is done from outside, because the temperature is being raised from 27 to 127 degrees Celsius. In this case, you need not convert into absolute, because it is a difference of two temperatures. So, whether you take temperature on the Celsius scale or on the absolute scale, it does not matter. See, when you read the problem, as I have been emphasizing, please read each word very carefully. Question 4. In an isothermal process, 1000 calories of heat was added to an ideal system, ideal gas system. So, process is isothermal. We have an ideal gas system. So, equation of state P v equal to mu r T can be applied if needed. So, what is the change in the internal energy of the gas? What is the work done on the gas? Since it is isothermal process, there is no change in temperature, hence no change in internal energy. So, d u is equal to 0. So, all the heat given is used in doing work, and heat given is 1000 calories, which is equal to 4186 joules, because 1 calorie is 4.186 joules. So, this is the total heat or work done, because d u is 0. So, this is the work done on the system. This is an interesting problem. A 100 gram ice cube at 0 degrees Celsius is converted into water at 0 degrees Celsius. How much energy is added to the ice cube? What is the work done on the cube during the change? And what is the change in the internal energy of the system? Now, you remember that if you want to convert ice into water, you will have to supply latent heat, and latent heat of ice is 80 calories per gram. So, for 100 grams, you add dq equal to 100 into 80 calories, that is 8000 calories, and convert that into joules. This is 3.35 into 10 to the power 4 joules. So, much heat is supplied. The change in the volume from ice to water is negligible. The external pressure can be assumed constant during melting. There is not much change in the atmosphere in a short time. The external pressure can be assumed to be constant during melting. So, dW is equal to PdV equal to 0. So, work done is 0. Therefore, whatever heat has been given is used in changing the internal energy. So, dU is dQ minus dW. dW is 0. So, dU is equal to dQ. Thus, the change in internal energy equals 3.35 into 10 to the power 4. There is no change in temperature, but there is no change in internal energy. Where has the internal energy gone? Recall from the last lecture, I told you the various, by that bar diagram, I showed you the various components of internal energy. And one of the components was the potential energy due to the molecular interaction. You see, you are converting ice into water. Ice, in ice, the molecules are packed very closely. In water, they are not packed so closely. So, you are changing, when you change from ice to water, you are changing the separation of the molecules. That means, you are pulling them slightly apart. And here is where the work goes. And the potential energy that these molecules gain goes into internal energy. So, the energy added or the work done has gone into pulling the molecules apart and thereby building the potential energy of the system. 1 mole of an ideal gas was allowed to expand isothermally at a temperature T from 4 liters at 6 atmosphere to 8 liters at 3 atmospheres. At what temperature did the process take place, and what was the amount of work done in the process? See, the process, the gas was allowed to expand isothermally. at temperature T, if it is isothermal, then P V is constant. So, P 1 V 1 is equal to P 2 V 2, and you can see that V 1 is 4 liters, P 1 is 6 atmospheres and the product is 24. Here the also V 2 is 8 liters and P 2 is 3 atmospheres. So, again the product is 24. So, P 1 V 1 equal to P 2 V 2, and it is a constant equal to 24. Now, using the ideal gas equation of state P 1 V 1 or P 2 V 2 equal to mu R T, we get T, which is P 1 V 1 by R. So, you can calculate, substitute the values and you will get T. So, this is the temperature at which the process took place. The work done is given by the, since the isothermal process, the work done is mu R T into log of V 2 by V 1. You see, since the examiner asks the work done in the process, in the isothermal process you know the work done is mu R T, but you did not know T. So, you have to find T from P V equal to mu R T, and you are given the data P 1 V 1 equal to P 2 V 2 is constant, and you use that in the equation of state and find T and use T now to get the work done. Work done is mu R T log of V 2 by V 1. So, substitute the values and you get the work done equal to 1685.4 joules. Another question, a mole of an ideal monoatomic gas. You see, monoatomic gas is given because you would need gamma, and gamma for monoatomic gas is 5 by 3. A mole because you would need mu. So, all this data is given. Initially at 0 degree Celsius is expanded adiabatically to 10 times its initial volume. What is the final temperature? So, we have to find the final temperature. That means, we need an adiabatic relation between temperature and volume, because volume is given and temperature is only initial temperature is given. So, we need a relation between volume and temperature. This we find from P V raised to power gamma is constant. Combine this with the equation of state P V equal to mu R T, in this case mu is 1. So, P V equal to R T, and we get the relation T V gamma minus 1 is equal to constant. So, now use T I V I to the power gamma minus 1 is equal to T F V F to the power gamma minus 1. All quantities are given, you can find T F. T F is 59 degrees K or minus 214 degrees Celsius. You know, you should expect that the temperature would decrease because the gas is expanded. When the gas is expanded, then the temperature decreases. We see that the adiabatic expansion leads to cooling. Does adiabatic compression lead to heating? You can use the same formula. Suppose it is compressed to 10 times, to 1/10 of its volume. V I by V F will be 10 and T F would be T I 10 to the power gamma minus 1, which is larger than T I. So, the final temperature would be 1267 Kelvin or 994 degrees Celsius. You see, since we are compressing, the work has to be done from outside and the temperature would rise. One mole of an ideal monoatomic gas undergoes expansion at constant pressure. So, note these words, constant pressure. What fraction of the heat supplied is available for the system to do work? If initial state is noted by I and the final state by F, then from equation of state we have P V I equal to R T I and P V F equal to R T F, because volume and temperature are changing. So, V F minus V Y is delta V, T F minus T I is delta T. So, we can write the work done P delta V, which is R delta T. Notice that if there is no increase in temperature, then delta U is equal to 0 and all the heat supplied is available for doing work. In case delta T is not 0, then delta U is not 0, it is equal to C V delta T. We saw last time d U equal to C V dt or delta U equal to C V delta T, and then use the first law of thermodynamics and you can write delta W by delta Q. Delta W we find is R d T. So, R d T and delta Q is delta U plus R d T or P d V, whatever you want to use, and you substitute the values along with the value of gamma and you can show that the ratio of the work done to the heat supplied is for a diatomic gas is 2 by 7, for a monoatomic gas it is 2 by 5. So, simple. One mole of an ideal monoatomic gas is adiabatically compressed to 10 times its initial pressure. find the increase in temperature. This we have done before, but let me repeat. Pressure is given, initial and final. So, temperature is only initial is given. So, we need a relation between P and T in an adiabatic process. Again, you know P V gamma is constant, use P V equal to R T also, and you will get the relation P 1 minus 1 by gamma by T is constant. So, substitute the values T F is T I into P F by P I. P F is 10 times, so it is 10 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma, and T I is given as 300 K. So, you can multiply and get the result. This is 753.6 degrees K. You see, not only you know mathematics, not only you should know physics, you should also expect what kind of result you are going to get. Here the gas is compressed, therefore you must expect that its temperature would rise. It is 300 K, it is 753. If by some chance, by mistake, mathematics or otherwise, you get the final temperature lower than the initial temperature, then you should suspect something has gone wrong, because the gas is compressed. The temperature has risen, has to arise, and therefore it must be higher than the initial temperature. So, these are some of the tips that I can give you for solving these problems. Another problem: 1 mole of an ideal gas is compressed to 1/10 of its volume at constant temperature. Constant temperature means isothermal process. It is then allowed to expand isothermally to its original volume. You know what is done? It is compressed to a certain volume. Then isothermally it is allowed to expand back. Obviously, there is no work done, but you can also do it mathematically. The work done during compression is R T log of V 2 by V 1, which is V 2 is 1/10 of the final volume, and therefore, you see it is minus 5740, because it is work done on the system. Work done during expansion, if the final volume is 10 times the initial volume, then the work done is R T log 10, which is again 5740, but with a plus sign. So, the total work done is 0. So, you compress it isothermally, expand it isothermally, no change in energy. In the same problem, what happens when the gas is allowed to expand to its original volume adiabatically? Now, the expansion is adiabatic, and you know the relation T F is T I V I by V F to the power gamma minus 1. Which is equal to, substitute the values and you can find the final temperature 65 K, and then you use the relation work done in an adiabatic process, mu r into T 1 minus T 2 by gamma minus 1, substitute the values and you will get 2929. This is the work done in expanding. The work done in compressing was this. Therefore, the net work done on the system is 5740 minus 2929, it is 2811 joules. This is an interesting problem. 100 moles of an ideal monoatomic gas undergo processes from A to B, from B to C, and back to A, from C to A. We are asked what is the ratio of internal energies in states A and C. In states A and C, we want to find internal energies. What do we need for internal energies? We know internal energy is associated with temperature. So, at each of these points, we must find the temperature. And since in ideal gas, and P and V is given, so P V equal to R T, and you get the temperatures. So, you get the temperatures in all three states. State A, temperature is 241 K. State B, temperature is 301 K. State C, the temperature is 60 Kelvin. And internal energy is a function of temperature. Therefore, the ratio of internal energy in state A to internal energy in state C, U A by U C, is 241 by 60, which is roughly 4. We also see that internal energy is maximum in state B, because the temperature is maximum in state B. In this case, we can go further. We can calculate, for example, the heat d Q supplied during the process A to B. For this, we calculate dU and dW during this process. You know, dQ would be dU plus dW. For monoatomic gas, you know, the molar specific heat is 3 by 2 times R. Therefore, the work done dU is 100 moles into 3 by 2 R into the temperature difference, it is 7479 joules. dW is the work done. Work done is the area under this curve, this area. This area consists of this rectangle plus this triangle. So, it is the area. So, you can find area is 500 kJ, 1000 joules. And dQ therefore is dU plus dW, and you can add the two. The answer is in thousands of joules. I wish to draw your attention to this. Here the pressure is in terms of kPa. Pa is the unit of pressure, which is Newton per meter square. So, you can use the pressure is here is 150 into 1000 Newtons per meter square, and volume of course is given in meter cube. So, you do not need to change anything. In this lecture, I have solved many problems for you, and I hope that you have followed the instructions, that you read the problem carefully, see what is given and what is hidden sometimes. Say, it says temperature this and the temperature does not change. That means, even if it is not given, the process is isothermal. So, please read the question carefully, read what relevant information you would require to solve this problem, and you know all the formula. Formulas, you can see there are only 3 or 4 formulas that we have used: PV equal to RT, dQ equal to dU plus PdV, the work done in isothermal system, mu RT into log of V2 by V1, work done in adiabatic process. These are only a few formulae which you can remember and apply whenever they are needed. So, if you know what is given and what is required, then you can solve this problem. And I hope also that this problem has given, these problems have given you some deeper understanding into how thermodynamics works. In the next lecture, we take up the second law of thermodynamics. And with that, this chapter on heat and thermodynamics would be over.